everyone. This is our online speaking class in which we are going to discuss all three parts of speaking. First, I will introduce you what actually is IELTS speaking. It is a conversation between examiner and candidate, and there are three parts. First is introduction, which we call interview as well. Second is speak at length, which we call cue card or 2-minute topic. And third part is discussion. And we call it follow-up question as well. Let's start with the speaking. First, I'm telling you it is conducted from 11 to 13 minutes. It is a conversation between examiner and candidate, and it is conducted separately. And these days, it is conducted virtual also. It is conducted virtually, like it is conducted on the computer or laptop, where you can go in a lab or in a, you can say, in front of a system which they set properly, and the examiner can conduct it online the way I am conducting today. So in this kind of class, you can have practice of that also, because in future there will be trend of virtual speaking more rather than one-to-one, face-to-face. Okay. So there are three parts in the speaking. First one is introduction, which we call interview, which is all about you. The first part is all about you. In this part, they ask you question related to you only. And second part is speak at length, cue card, in which they give you some cues. And then you can speak on that topic after 1 minute preparation. And third part is discussion or follow up. In this part, they ask you questions related to that topic. For example, the topic is favorite movie, so the question will be related to movie only. Sometimes they ask other question as well. You cannot say why they are asking other than movies. It is up to them. And the time of speaking test, generally we call it 10 to 15, but is conducted between 11 to 13 minutes. And it purely depends on examiner, because they have a slot, so they can take less time also, they can take more time also, and it depends on you. Okay. And there are four criteria on which your band scores are awarded. And these four criteria are fluency and coherence, then lexical resource, grammatical range and accuracy, pronunciation. Means in your speaking, they check how good you are at fluency and lexical resource, which we call vocabulary as well. Then GRA, which is grammatical range and accuracy, means what kind of sentences you are using, the same way we have writing. And the last fourth criteria, jo main hai, that is pronunciation. Fine. In pronunciation, they check how you pronounce the word. Now, no one is a native speaker out of you. So might you can use like your pronunciation cannot be like native English speakers. So it's fine if you have mother tongue influence, but it should not be more. Sometimes some people have a lot of mother tongue influence. A person is Punjabi, so you can see that from their English that this person is Punjabi. And if the person is Gujarati, so you can see that this person is Gujarati from their English only. All right. Okay. So how it is conducted? You will go to our room and there will be an examiner. First, you have to greet them. You will be taking your passport with you and they check your identification. These days you have to wear mask as well. If it is virtual speaking, then also till you don't start speaking, you have to carry mask because the other people are there. So, and they check your passport, your identification, then they start the test. First, they give their introduction that I am so and so, I am from IDP, I'm going to conduct your speaking, and then they record it. Don't get distracted from recording. Some students, you know what they do. Bolo kya karte hai? Recording, recorder ko hi dekh ke bolne lag jate hai. They don't make eye contact to examiner. Eye contact means confidence. You look confident when you maintain eye contact with people. Okay. But that doesn't mean that you're going to stare at examiner. You have to maintain eye contact and it has to be decent one. And yes, now you have to wear masks so your eyes speak. So you have to be more expressive in your body language. All right. So you have to be careful that you are confident, but you are not but like you are not staring at the examiner and you are not looking at the recorder only. कुछ लोग क्या करते हैं, वो सिर्फ रिकॉर्डर को ही देख के सारी स्पीकिंग दे आते हैं, एग्जामिनर को देखते भी नहीं. एंड समटाइम्स सम स्टूडेंट्स दे गेट डिस्ट्रैक्टेड बिकॉज ऑफ एग्जामिनर्स एक्सप्रेशन. गाइज, एग्जामिनर्स एक्सप्रेशन डजंट मैटर. इट व्हाट मैटर इज योर स्पीकिंग, हाउ यू आर आंसरिंग द क्वेश्चन. ओके, दे आर वेल ट्रेन्ड एंड वेरी फेयर एग्जामिनर, सो यू नीड नॉट टू वरी दैट द एग्जामिनर वॉज मेकिंग फेस लाइक दिस. Might be he or she was not interested in my speaking. No, it is their job. It is not about interest. But yes, you have to be very, you can say, you should speak well. It should be interesting conversation so that they can get engrossed in your speaking and they can give you more score. All right. Okay. Now we are going to start with our part one. Anybody is having any question, you can ask me, because in this part one, I would like you to participate. You have to answer the questions. Wrong honge, toh we will correct you, because it is not exam, it is class. All right? Yeah, one more thing I would like to tell you. Sometimes the examiner is writing something. Some people say they are writing the time. Some people say they are writing the band score. You need not to get distracted by that. वो जो भी लिखेंगे आपका अपना स्कोर आपकी स्पीकिंग पे ही होएगा, और वैसे भी इट इज नॉट क्लियर व्हाट दे आर राइटिंग. ओके, सो यू नीड नॉट टू वरी. एंड देयर आर थ्री पार्ट्स व्हाट आई वाज टॉकिंग अबाउट. फर्स्ट पार्ट इज ऑल अबाउट यू. सो इन दिस फर्स्ट क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस फ्यू लेटेस्ट क्वेश्चंस ऑफ रियल एग्जाम, सो दैट यू कैन आंसर वन बाय वन. We can share the ideas and I can give you the feedback. We can discuss also. All right, so let's start. The very first question they ask you, what is your full name? Aap kahoge, I am Hema Patel. Then I will ask you, what can I call you? What shall I call you? Then you can say, you can call me by my first name, Hema. Aap isme bhi kai student kya karte hain? Aap kai to cramped answer pehle hi taiyar rakhte hain. Aur kai pata kya keh dete hain? You can call me by my first name, Ricky. They start giving their nickname, short names. You need not to. Here you have to give your first name, but you need not to say, you can call me by my first name and all. So you can simply say, I am Hema Patel. So when I ask you, what shall I call you? You can call me Hema, or you can call me by my first name, Hema also. Okay, now I am going to ask you questions one by one. First question, Hema Patel only. Yes, Hema, where are you from?
I'm from Himatnagar.
Where is it?
It is located in Sabarkantha.
Okay, in which state?
State Gujarat.
Gujarat, because here we have candidates from other states also. So here you can talk about your state as well. Like, I'm from Chandigarh. Fine. Jasveer is from?
Ma'am, I am from Sangheda, which is located in Barnala.
Okay, do you live in a house or an apartment, Hema?
I live in a house.
What kind of house it is?
It is big house.
Okay. Can you describe your house?
My house is located in a Kankanol near Himatnagar, and my house is big and it has a three-story building, and I am living in a first-story building, and my house color, it is white color, and it is neat and clean, and I am living with my family.
Okay, so then we can ask Jasveer. Jasveer, what can you see from the windows of your house?
Mama, I can see nature from the window. I can see scenic view from my window of the house, nature. Well, I love to see a nature in the morning time. It's very helpful to stay healthy.
All right, next question. Let's talk about names. Do you normally remember people's names, Jasveer?
Ma'am, I remember people's name by repeating again and again.
Okay, Hema, is it easy for you to remember names?
No, ma'am, it's not easy.
Why?
Because it's difficult to remember the name.
Okay, why it is difficult?
But I only remember the person's face.
Okay, so you remember the people by their face. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Have you ever forgotten someone's name?
Yes, ma'am. Sometimes I've forgotten the person's names because I don't know that person and so I can't remember her person, his name.
Okay. So you can say, I don't remember names of those whom I meet only once or twice. But if I know that person, of course, I remember their names. Okay. Okay, now I'm asking the questions to Jasveer only. Do you wear different clothes on special occasion?
Yes, I love to wear special clothes on different occasions. I felt very happy when I wear different clothes on different occasions.
I feel very happy, okay? I feel very happy, not felt, okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Have you ever worn traditional clothes?
Well, no, ma'am. I haven't wear any traditional clothes on any occasion. Mostly, I wear modern clothes. Like.
So you can describe that I mostly wear modern clothes. I don't wear traditional clothes, and because these days it is not mandatory that even on traditional occasion we have to wear traditional clothes. If you are giving such kind of answer. Otherwise, you can say I belong to Punjab, of course, on many occasions or festivals. I like to wear traditional Punjabi attire. Okay.
Okay, yeah. Ma'am.
When you were a child, did you ever wear special clothes?
Yes, ma'am. When I was a child, that time I wear a Punjabi suit on my friend's birthday. Actually, he
invited me. You can answer like this. I used to wear. Because the question is, when you were a child, did you wear special clothes? So you can say, yes, I used to wear special clothes in my school functions, on traditional events. So you can talk about that. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
All right, Hema, now I'm asking you the questions. What makes people smile?
Sometimes make people smile. So I gifted some things and I do something for a person.
No, this is general. That's what makes people smile?
What makes person smile?
Log person smile. Kyun khush hote hain? Smile dete hain.
Yes, ma'am.
When they are happy, when they are meeting somebody for the first time, or when they are greeting someone for the day, jaise abhi hum sabse pehle jab milte hain, what we do? We give smile. Good evening, ma'am. Everyone. Aap sabne bhi. Good evening, ma'am. So we greet somebody by giving smile. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
So what makes people smile? But the question is, what makes people smile? So you can say inner happiness, their satisfaction. Okay? Sometimes some yes, kind ma'am. Of achievement. These things make them happy. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you smile often?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, why so?
Because I am glad.
Okay, so you are
to learn the English.
You can say I'm a happy person. You can say
yes,
this,
ma'am.
Okay?
I'm happy.
How important is happiness to you?
When I am with my family, that time I am very happy.
Okay. Can you tell me about the time when you did something to make everyone happy?
Yes, ma'am. Recently, I cooked the special dinner for my family.
So how you will answer this question, Hema? You can say, yes, last week only I cooked special meal for my family and it made everyone happy. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
All right, let's talk to Jasveer now. Do you carry a purse or a wallet with you?
Well, I like to carry a purse in a critical situation,
it is a purse or wallet jo hum roz leke jate hain. What is my question?
Ma'am, yes.
Critical situation, why it will be critical situation? Daily you go for class. When you go for class daily, you carry with you purse or wallet. My question is, do you carry a purse or a wallet?
Ma'am, I carry a bag when I go to my class.
That's it. Very good. Have you ever lost your bag or wallet?
No, I haven't lost my bag because I care a lot my bag.
So you can answer like this. I have never lost it because I'm very careful. When I carry a bag, I always leave a place by rechecking whether I have carried it or not. Okay? Yes, okay, Hema. Hema, let's talk about relaxation. What relaxation techniques do you know?
Yoga and do some exercises.
Okay.
And go some picnic.
What relaxation techniques do you know? You said yoga. Then you said?
Do some exercises.
Yes. That's it. Is relaxation important?
Yes, ma'am. Relaxation is most important to our body.
Okay. Do you think vacations are a good source of relaxation?
Yes, ma'am. Vacation is a good source of the relaxation.
How?
Because when persons are busy, people are busy in a daily schedule in a 24/7 life. So person go to outside and get some relaxation. So it is very important for the life.
All right. Why do people like vacations?
People like vacation because as I told you, people are busy in a daily life schedule, 24/7 culture. So vacation is most important for the people.
Okay. What did you do on your last vacation?
On my last vacation, I wanted to go in a Shimla Manali tour.
You have used I wanted to go in. This is wrong. Simple. And don't repeat my question. If I say, what did you do on last vacation? On last occasion, simply say, I went to Shimla and Manali. And I had a great time there. That's it. Don't make it complicated, okay?
Okay, ma'am.
And don't use went and go together. Okay, and do you like going to vacation?
Yes, ma'am.
Where are you planning to go next?
I am planning to go next, Goa.
Goa, why so?
Because when I was a child, that time I went to Goa. So I don't remember the things.
Very good. Very nice. So now I want to visit there and I want to recollect. Yeah, you can say I want to cherish those childhood memories as well. Fine. If you remember.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, let's talk about reading, Jasveer.
Okay, ma'am.
Do you like to read?
Yes, I love to read because when with the help of reading, I can enhance my knowledge.
What is a good place for you to read?
I think I think library is the best place to read any books, because there are no anyone who can disturb us.
Let's talk about agriculture and farm. Jasveer, okay. When was the last time you were on a farm?
Well, I remember when I was in the 5th or 6th standard, that time I visited in the farm with my cousin. I did a lot of fun with him, and there were many different kinds of trees when I saw my first time.
Would you like to live and work on a farm?
Yes, I want to live in a farm because it's a very important part of our life. We cannot survive without the farm. It's only a source of income.
No, I'm asking you. This question is for you. Would you like to live and work? You can say, yes, but I don't think that now I can do this. But after my retirement, I can plan to live and work on farm. I can live in a farmhouse, I can grow plants, but presently I don't have any plan like this, okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, guys, in the first part, try to speak more, but that doesn't mean you are giving, in the first part you can speak less, but it doesn't mean you don't speak at all. You have to justify your question. You have to would you like to live on a farm? Or is, like, you can say, no, I don't want to live. But yes, I can think about it later after my retirement, because now I want to go abroad for my further studies, and I cannot plan to live or work on a farm. So you can even tell the reality also. Of course, you all are going abroad for your further studies. How can you live on a farm now? Okay? All right,
okay, Hema. Ma'am.
Yeah. All right, Hema, let's talk about traveling. Do you often travel by car?
Yes, ma'am. I travel by car sometimes.
Do you prefer to sit in the front of the car or in the back?
I prefer to sit in the front of the car.
What would you do if you get stuck on the road and your car has some problem? If your car broke down and you, what will you do? For example, you're traveling by car and on the way it stops working and you are stuck on the road. What will you do?
I call the mechanic.
Pardon? I will call the mechanic if mechanic is not there. So how will
that? I will.
Yeah. First, I will try if there is any workshop nearby. Or if I have the number of my mechanic, I can call him. But if I am far from my city or the area, so I have to call my friend or family member to help me in that situation, okay? Because I cannot ask any stranger on the road to help me. Got it?
Yes, ma'am.
Let's talk about flowers, Hema.
Yes, ma'am.
When was the last time you bought flowers?
Last time I bought some flower in a last month.
Okay. Do you have flowers in your house?
Yes, ma'am.
Speak more. In the first question also, when was the last time you bought flowers? You said last month. For what purpose? You can talk about that. Actually, I went to meet a friend, so I took flowers with me. Or it was my friend's birthday, I gave flowers to her. Or simply you can say, there was kind of religious ceremony in my house, so I bought flowers for that. So you can add on this. And my next question is, do you have flowers in your house? You said, yes. Here you can even talk about the types of flowers, how you grow them. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
So please answer this question again. Do you have flowers in your house?
Yes, ma'am. I have a flower in my house.
Is it a one flower? You said I have a flower.
Flowers.
So you will not say a flower. You can say there are few flower plants, or there are many flowers I have grown in my house, like rose, sunflower. You can talk about that. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
It is lily or any other type of flower. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Or if it is only one plant, then also you can say, I have recently planted a rose. You can say plant. Yeah, I have recently grown a rose plant in my house because I love the fragrance of rose. So you can say this way also, okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Next question is, in your country, is it common to use flowers to celebrate special occasions?
Yes, ma'am. Flower is most important in a celebration, like a birthday celebration, debt ceremony, wedding ceremony, love express, yes, etc.
There are so many occasions when people give flowers to others. So flowers are part of every type of, you can say, occasion of our life. Fine?
Okay, ma'am.
All right. Now I will ask you a few introduction questions to Jasveer.
Okay, ma'am.
Jasveer, do you think history is important?
Yes, ma'am. History is very important. With the help of history, we can stay aware in our life. Because when we read any history, we can learn many things about in the past. In the past, there are many people who mistake a lot. With the help of that mistakes, we can stay aware.
Okay. Why do you think history is important?
Well, there are many things. I think it's very important. With the help of history, we can learn many things about our culture, because nowadays culture is disappearing because life is very faster. People haven't enough time to read to care about our culture. So mostly children should read history to know about our culture.
Okay, so you think history, like it should be added into schools? Like it is already there in the schools, but it should be mandatory subject, you want to say. But see, the question was not about schools, guys. You have to be careful. My question, do you think history is important? Of course, one should know the history of their country, family. You can talk about that. And why you think so? Because if it is my country, to get connected to our country, our roots. So why history is important? Of course, to know about our country, world, past, we should know. And from the past, we can learn about our future. And same goes for even family history as well. We can come to know what kind of problems, what kind of struggles our ancestors did. And we can, we can feel proud of them and we can learn from them. Okay, so my next question is, is it possible to teach children history at the museum? Is it possible? Of course it is possible. Yeah. Yes, it is very easy to teach history at museum, because at museums there are so many things related to history which are kept. Even ancient, you can say, from clothes to utensils to transcripts, so many things are there in the museums. And when children visit those museums and those places, and they can come to know about the history of that particular, you can say, ancient item which is kept. So this way they can even remember more, or they can, you can say, they can learn more. Whatever we see, we remember for a long time. So you can even talk about
it. Okay, ma'am.
All right, now I'm asking you a few questions to Hema. Hema, are you a morning person?
Yes, ma'am, I am a morning person.
Do you wake up early in the morning?
Yes, ma'am, I am wake up in the morning because lots of work to do.
I wake up early because I have to complete so many tasks. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
What are the things that you do every morning?
Every morning I do some exercises and some homework, and I go to temple, etc. Ma'am.
So yeah, you can talk about one or two things. You need not to worry that you have to add all the things you do. So you can add one or two things which you have, which you do regularly. Like you go to temple daily. So you can talk about that. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, Emma, let's talk about mathematics. Did you have mathematics in your secondary school?
Yes, ma'am. Mathematics is our mandatory subject.
Mandatory. Pronunciation
as mandatory
subject. So you can say, yes, I have studied because it was mandatory subject in school. Okay. Did you like maths lessons?
No, ma'am. I don't like maths lessons because I don't interested in maths.
Any reason?
Because I can't understand the mathematic techniques, so I don't like the maths subject.
All right. Okay. Hema, my question was, did you like, because I'm talking about your school days, now you're not studying that anymore. So your answer should be no. I did not like it at all. I used to feel bored when I used to study math because it was very confusing. So you have to tell about that time. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
So you have to be, guys, careful. Jasveer, Hema, Narin, you have to be careful that while answering, if the question is in present, you have to give answer in present. If past, it should be in the past. You can talk about that particular time. My next question is, would you choose to study math now? If yes, why? If no, why not?
No, ma'am, I don't choose maths now.
Why?
Because I don't like that subject. So I don't like to choose this subject.
Do you use math to improve your life? If so, what are some examples? See, in daily life, we use math. We do calculations. Fine? Even if
yes,
we don't like math, we have to, you know, use math in our daily life for so many things. Okay. So do you use math to improve your life? If so, what are some examples? So you can say, though I did not like math in my school, but it is very important, I think, subjects. That's why it was mandatory in school. So in daily life, of course, I'm using math to maintain data, to keep records, as I'm working as technician, right? Do you have trees around where you live?
Yes, ma'am. There are many trees where I live. Ma'am, I can't remember the tree's name.
Mango tree is easy to say. Fine.
Okay, ma'am.
I said, do you have trees around where you live? Yes, there are few trees. And there are few mango trees around my house. Just add on. Nobody's going to check. Fine?
Okay, ma'am.
Do you like trees?
Yes, ma'am. I like tree.
Okay. Why so? Though it's an odd question, but they generally ask you why.
Because when I watch the tree, I get relaxed, refreshed. So I like the tree.
Have you ever planted any tree?
No, ma'am.
Why?
Nowadays, I am busy with my daily schedule.
Though we should be, you know, we are these days, we are environment conscious, you know, we want to save our environment. We should grow trees, but if you're not growing, doesn't matter, Hema, you can say, no, I haven't planted, but my family members, they do. Because they plant, so, and they take care of those plants and trees. So I'm busy at my work. I can't take, you can say, I don't get time to take care of the trees. So I have asked my family members to do so. So you can say, even you're doing something for the environment, but you have not yourself grown the trees. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
What kind of trees are more common in your hometown?
In my hometown, mango tree are very common.
Okay. If I ask you why so, then you can say, people of my state love to eat mangoes, so they generally grow mango trees. So you can answer like this, okay?
Okay, ma'am.
All right, now turn, Jasveer, your turn. Are you an honest person?
Yes, I am honest person.
Who will say I'm not? Okay, why do you think you are an honest person? Jasveer, you confidently said I am an honest person. Why? See, ab kaun kahega main imandar nahi? So abhi aapne kaha I am an honest person, so you can say of course I am an honest person. Who will say I am not? And secondly, you can say I give credit of this. Why you think I? Because I never do cheating with anybody. I am very loyal and honest. And my parents have taught me this great skill, lifetime, you can say, this great life skill, that a person has to be honest with work, with studies, with people. Okay, Jasveer? So you can justify this. See, वैसे तो हर कोई कहेगा, but why you think, if they are asking why you think you are, do you think that you are an honest person? You can say, because I do not do any kind of dishonesty. And why do you think being honest is good?
There are many reasons of being honest is very important. Ma'am, it's very important.
What was my question? Why a person should be honest?
Yeah.
Hema, can you answer this?
Honesty is a very good thing because it is most important for our life, because we
simply, you can say honesty is the best policy. Like we say, you can say a person should be honest, and the reason is people trust that person more. If a person is not honest, that person can easily lose trust of others. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
All right, next questions are about furniture. What piece of furniture do you like the most in your house, Hema?
I like the furniture in the most dining table. Because we... in my family, we can sit together and we can eat together. So, dining table is my favorite furniture.
Is there any kind of furniture you would like to buy?
Yes, ma'am. I like to buy traditional dining table because I want to eat.
You want to?
I want to eat like a Rajasthani dining table.
Okay, so you want to buy traditional, like you can say dining, and you want to eat food on that. Any reason
yes,
for
ma'am.
That?
Because I like to eat.
See, dining thodi, you'd like to eat what? Dining.
Okay.
You said, I want to buy a traditional dining. So reason will be related to dining, not food. Food can be served on any place. So simply say,
yes, ma'am.
I would like to buy a traditional dining for my house because it will enhance the beauty of my house and the traditional big dining. you can say can be used for, you know, when so many guests, it can accommodate so many guests because it will have at least 12 chairs. You can add on that. A big dining table with a lot of chairs so that so many people can have meal together. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
All right. Now I'm going to ask last, you can say questions, last few questions for today's class. It is about recycling. So one by one, you both can answer. Why recycling is important, Jasveer?
Ma'am, well, it's very helpful to our environment. With the help, well, we can reduce many things like water, like ma'am, bottle, paper. With the help of paper, we can make our flowers. It's very helpful to enhance our environmental beauty, and we can keep our home.
Pardon? Can you repeat? Why recycling is important?
Ma'am, recycling is very important part of our life. With the help of recycling, we can save our environment and
ma'am? Very right. This is an introduction question. It's enough, Jasveer. You need not to worry that I have to say other more things. Of course, recycling is important for an environment, for our environment. We are going to throw things. Of course, we will not save our environment. Fine. So it's better. It is better to recycle the thing to save the environment. Yes, Hema.
Okay.
Did you recycle things when you were a child?
Yes, ma'am.
What did you recycle? Did you recycle? I remember that my parents and my teacher used to ask me to recycle papers, or you can say paper, newspaper and paper. But during childhood, I was not very aware, so I did not recycle. Now I make sure that I recycle things. Okay? So you can give the example when we have not recycled anything. Okay. Yeah, Jasveer?
Yes, ma'am. When I was child that time, I haven't enough knowledge to recycling anything. So that time, I didn't any recycle.
Very nice. This is also a good answer. Very good. All right. Is recycling popular in your country, Hema? Last question.
Yes, ma'am. Recycling is very popular in my country because nowadays, weather is very polluting. So it is very important for the life because some diseases are spread in the polluted nature. So recycling is very important.
Important. Your answer is about recycling is important. But my question was, is recycling popular in your country? That so many people are doing it or not? Popular means काफी famous है recycling. तो आप इसका answer क्या देंगी हेमा? आप बोलेंगी these days, thanks to so much awareness about environment, many people are doing recycling and it is becoming popular day by day. Popular, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
All right, guys, this is the end of today's class. See you tomorrow.